Now, we know that in primary lymphedemas, there are subsets of genetic abnormalities that predispose or determine that lymphedema will occur. So there are families in which a mutation that can be passed from generation to generation will determine that on average 50% of the offspring of an affected individual will have this problem. We said earlier that acquired lymphedema happens when normal lymphatics are traumatized through surgery or radiation therapy, but that may not be entirely or strictly true. There may actually be genetic variables present in the population that are comparable in their impact to what we see in these very well-defined inherited disorders. So that, in fact, patients may come to breast cancer surgery or breast cancer-related radiation therapy with a genetic predisposition to be in the 25% versus the 75%. We don't know yet what those variables are genetically or in terms of the phenotype of the individual, but there are early and suggestive clues in research that suggest that these factors may actually be operative. And in future, as we define some of these genetic variables, it will actually help to identify higher risk subgroups, much like the genetic variables have defined subgroups of patients that are at higher risk for developing breast cancer and other kinds of cancers.